Hey everyone. Yeah, we had a great bonfire last night. You might be seeing this on a upcoming video. Take note of those. You can hear the tornado sirens in the background. Must be noon, first Saturday of the month. They're just shutting down now, so they test them every month, first Saturday. Probably do it in your area too. All right, well, I got a few things to update you on. Let's go head over to the pheasants. All right, well, there's Mr. Rooster. What a cool bird. Look how colorful he is. All right, let's go check on the nest real quick. All right, so good news is she's moved the one egg closer to getting it in the nest. That's good. And the rest of them are in there. I can't really see very well how many are in there now. It's kind of dark in there, and I really don't want to move anything. So let me take a count here off camera. Okay, unofficially, I see about 9 in there. That's cool. She's been laying every day thereabouts. So there she is over there. That's really cool. So she's not sitting yet, so she's not ready to start hatching these, so when she does, I'll let you guys know. All right, got something else to show you guys. Yeah, so we mowed the grass for the first time, and well, we started using this. Check this out. Yeah, that doesn't look good. Left side pump blew out on us, not even a quarter of the way through the mowing. So Master Outdoorsman and I had to get the Jubilee and the front bucket, took that off, and then hooked some chains up to the arms and had to lift this thing up and bring it over here. So I'll be replacing that pump or rebuilding it or whatever I need to do. I got to get it apart today and figure out what's going on with it, so I'll let you guys know what happens with that. So we had to finish the mowing with this. Yeah, we had to pull the old John Deere out of retirement. Sharp up the blades, you know, get the mowing deck back on, and you know, get her jumped and started, and yeah, did a great job. It mowed all this, about 3 acres worth. We cut around the house, and yeah, Master Outdoorsman was on that for a while. It's a lot harder to do on this than it is on the zero turn, but it gets the job done. We used it for 20 years out here before we got that zero turn, so this was our everyday mower, and I guess it might be again for a while. Yeah, there's a Jubilee. There's the chains we used. We had to lift it up from the front. The rear couldn't do it. There's just too much weight with the blade back there. Just couldn't lift everything up. All right, I think the chickens want to be on camera. Let's go check them out. All right, here they are. Look at them all. These guys are so cool. Look at Road King go. I just love the way these things look. And that little Silky in there is just the noisiest little thing. He's so funny, though. And this guy, he tries to run to roost here. He's outside right now. You can see the fence is off. He's not jumping all over. And you got this guy right here. He just, I don't know. Oh, there you go. You can see he's real vocal too. He's pretty funny. But he doesn't like me coming around here. He's going to follow me around. Check him out. All right, well, hopefully this is showing up through the fence here. I don't know. I can't really see the screen very well. The sun's behind me. But he is pretty, though. He's got blue in his feathers. I don't know if the camera's picking that up, but there's like a bluish green in his feathers. That's really nice. All right. All right, guys, that's all you're getting for camera time. All right, well, we got some new tires for the Jubilee. These are 5.5 by 16 6-ply, and we're going to have these put on. Master Outdoors is going to go up to the shop where he works and have these put on, hopefully by Monday, so we can get the tractor going again. I took the 8N tires off and stuck them on the Jubilee, but we were able to do the driveway once, and then one of those front tires blew out. So, and these are original 1953 tires. I think that's just amazing. Definitely going to keep them and put them up on the wall. So I wanted to update you guys on the trailer project here and how disappointed I am in that rust bullet. I mean, if you look, rust came through everywhere. I did everything the can said to do, but it doesn't appear to have worked. As you can see, it's rusting again. So, yeah, not good. I'm gonna have to redo this again. It looks like something different. It has been used a couple of times, the trailer that is, but still, this stuff just, it didn't work. So, that's too bad. I kind of thought it was going to be the end all to this trailer and the rusting it had, but looks like no. So I'll keep you guys updated on what I end up doing with this too. It's not, horribly bad, and it is usable. It is a trailer, but I kind of thought it would last at least more than, 6 months. All right, so it is a beautiful day out here. It's going to be in the mid-60s today, so just beautiful day. Well, Master Outdoorsman's picking up something that I'm going to put on video here in the week, I think. We'll see how it works out, but he's pretty excited, and we'll be working on his new toy that he got. Hopefully not too much. Hopefully it'll be a pretty easy fix, and he'll be able to have fun. So, all right, guys. Well, I appreciate you watching, and I put up the dog video again, a shortened version of it, so that it'd play a little better on YouTube, and who knows, maybe it'll get picked up by some viral video people. Wouldn't that be cool? But I had some suggestions from a few people to shorten it up a little bit, and that's what I did. So if you're seeing that come back into your box again, I tried to wait 6 days to release it, but apparently it still popped into people's boxes. So sorry about that. Didn't mean to have you guys watch it again, but all right. All right, guys. Thanks for watching.